So, what happened on November 10? We can summarize it with one letter and one number. M1. Let's talk about it right after the intro. Hi guys, and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco and this is your weekly fix of tech news, leaks, rumors and opinions, everything about Apple and their competitors. If you're fond of this type of content, subscribe now, leave a comment below, hit the like button, and don't forget to enable notifications so you don't miss the next video. We have finally got to see the new ARM-based Macs, and oh boy, exciting times are upon us. But before we get to the Macs, let's put the spotlight on the most important player in the game, Apple's ARM-based M1 chip, its first publicly available 5-nanometer processor in a computer. It comes with 8 cores, 4 high performance and 4 power efficient ones. M1 not only combines 8 GPU cores and 16 core neural engine, but it goes even further by adding high bandwidth, low latency memory and unifying it on a system on a chip, which dramatically improves performance and power efficiency. Now the Macs. If we look at Apple's website, you will see there are no more MacBook Air models that are powered by Intel. 2 variations only, both powered by M1. The one in the lower end spectrum comes with 1 GPU core less, or 7 to be precise, comparable to the more powerful one, which by default has 8 fully unlocked. MacBook Air variants do not have cooling fans, so you've been warned. Don't get surprised if there is some sort of throttling, but let's wait for the real world tests. As far as battery life goes, with MacBook Air models, according to Apple, you can expect up to 18 hours of use on a single charge. That's a lot. Both variations come with 8 gigs of unified memory as base option, but you can reconfigure it up to 16. Tier 1 MacBook Air starts from $999 with 256 gigs of storage. The second more powerful MacBook Air from $1249 with 512 gigs of storage capacity. Either way, if you're not satisfied with storage configurations, you can go up to 2 terabytes, which will cost you a bit. Although Apple did not mention the frequency of M1, it's kind of interesting that MacBook Pro models are also available with Intel processors. That can mean 3 things. A, Apple's in-house CPUs are still not as capable as high-end Intel alternatives. B, there may be issues with some more demanding professional apps that are still better optimized for Intel, so Apple prefers not to take any chances with some professionals. And C, there will be pros that will be hesitant and cautious until they don't get the first glimpse of M1 real-life performance. If you think of any other reason why, please share in the comment section below. 2 lower-end Pro models are both powered by Apple Silicon. At least in terms of processing power, they seem kind of identical to Tier 2 MacBook Air. I mean, in many ways, beside the fan, touch bar, better speakers, and better display, it seems like there are not many differences. There is in a battery life though, with Apple promising up to 20 hours with Pro versions. The most affordable MacBook Pro with 256 gigs of storage starts from $1299, and 512 gigs of storage option starts from $1499. What's bad, at least for me, is that every MacBook that is powered by M1 chip is available only with 2 Thunderbolt ports. MacBook Pro models with M1 allow you to choose only between 8 and 16 gigs of memory, which may not be enough for some more demanding tasks and applications. Lucky enough, Intel alternatives have kept 4 Thunderbolt ports and you can pump up to 32 gigs of RAM. Now, do I have to mention 720p camera? No. Before we continue, guys, if you like what you've seen so far, please hit the like button, leave a comment below and subscribe. It means a lot for the future of this channel. Thank you. Now let's continue. Finally, the Mac Mini. Personally for me, that's the most welcome Mac. There was no change in the form factor, at least not yet. But it packs a lot for a great price. Same story. 8 core CPU, 8 core GPU, fan cooling, 8 or 16 gigs of memory, between 256 and all the way up to terabytes of storage configurations. Comparable to MacBooks that I mentioned previously, it has a rich I/O, 2 Thunderbolt ports, 2 USB-A, HDMI, what else? SD card. You do have an Intel-based option as well, with more upgrades, obviously, but still, this is not a subject of this video, so let's skip it. Now, I guess you can already conclude potential answers should you buy any of these devices that were introduced yesterday by Apple or not. I mean, you can, but I'm not suggesting. First, in terms of design, MacBook Air or MacBook Pro are almost identical to previous iterations. There's nothing visually exciting on these machines. This is also the first gen product, so you may want to wait a little bit, at least to see initial reviews. Don't get me wrong, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. I just think, even if the new MacBook Air and MacBook Pro laptops with Apple Silicon are evolutions in almost every way, especially in terms of balance between power and efficiency, it's just a spark of the future and things that are coming. Now, if there was a device that I would buy, it would probably be new Mac Mini. Amazing price with M1 and cooling and solid I/O, but that's me. That's all. Thank you for watching Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.